want your app to distinguish between establishments that are open for business and establishments that are temporarily or permanently closed, the Places API has a field called Business Status that can help you do that. This video will tell you about our new field, Business Status, that represents the state of an establishment. This new field will replace an old field called Permanently Closed. Before now, the only states represented in the Places API were permanently closed or not, as indicated by the Boolean flag, permanently underscore closed in our place details and place search endpoints. If that field wasn't marked true, it might mean that the business was operating, or it might just mean unknown. We couldn't represent a temporary closure or even distinguish between whether we knew a business was operating versus if we just didn't have information about that business's operational status. In order to represent more than just two states, we have created a new enum field, business underscore status. This enum has three possible values: operational, closed temporarily, and closed permanently. This field can be used with place search requests and with place details requests. Operational indicates if the business owner has marked their business as open in Google My Business. Closed temporarily and closed permanently correspond to the same states that businesses can mark in Google My Business. Google also draws from additional authoritative data sources to determine if establishments are operational or closed. If we have no data about the place's status, the business status field is not returned in the response. Due to the uncertainty of whether a true value for this field represents a permanent or temporary closure, we recommend that you stop using permanently closed and use business status instead. You can use the business status field immediately with HTTP calls to the Places API or through our various client libraries, including the client-side Places library in the Maps JavaScript API and the server-side libraries for Go, Java, Node.js, and Python. This field will also be included in the next releases of the Places SDK for Android and the Places SDK for iOS. You can subscribe to the release notes for each of these SDKs to get notified when the next release is available. Now that you know how to identify whether a place is operational, you can learn about the related field, opening underscore hours, to get the daily schedule of when a place is open for visitors or customers. Check out that video to see how to get both opening hours and the calculation of whether a place is open right now or at a specific time. Thanks for watching and happy coding!